students, so today we'll start with the new chapter, that is chapter number 11 of standard 9, that is the construction. So in the first exercise, there are the questions that which we have to construct the angles of the given measures. So what we'll do today, we will construct measure of 12 angles with the help of compass. So let's start, let's begin it. First one, that is angle 60 degree. So we should remember that this is the base to construct any angle. If you want to construct any measure angle with the help of the compass, so 60 degree is the base that you have to construct it. Let's learn that how to construct 60 degree. For that, we should first draw a ray. So this ray, we can see that this could be of any measure. Let us give that point O and point A. So OA is the ray. Now with the help of rounder compass, we should take any arbitrary radius. Now remember students, throughout all the angles, we should take the radius of 2 cm. For all the angles, we should keep it 2 and we never change it, which is not compulsory. You can keep any arbitrary radius if you wish, but let's keep it same. Now at point O, we should keep O as a center and we should draw an arc of that radius. You can see that which intersect here, let us give that point M. Now we should keep the same radius and we'll draw another arc from point M of same radius which intersect the previous arc. I did not change it, remember this. Now this intersecting point is point N. Now you must join this. Let us join ON. So if I'll give this as point B, so when you measure this, measure angle AOB, so this angle must be 60. Now why it is 60? So let me tell you. If I'll measure this MN, so MN is same as ON and is same as OM. So you can see that this triangle OMN is an equilateral triangle and the measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle is must be 60. So this is a kind of justification. With the second angle, and now we'll construct the double of 60, that is 120 degree. Let's see, it is an obtuse angle which we have to construct right now. So again we have to do the double of this. So as usual, we'll construct the ray OA. Again, this could be of any length, any measure. Let us give the length, the vertex O and A. As we discussed earlier, with the help of the rounder, this is a 2 cm radius. You can take any arbitrary radius. As O is the center, we should construct an arc. This arc, you can see, which is intersecting the ray OA at a point, we should give that point M. Keep the same radius as we discussed earlier, we are not going to change the length of this radius. At point M, we should put, we'll make as a center and we'll draw an arc. So as we discussed earlier, if I'll give this point N, so N will be 60 degree. I'll keep again the same radius and from point N, we should construct another arc. Let me give this point as point P and I will draw ray OP. So you can see here, this point, if I'll give point B, so this angle AOB is 120 degrees. Let us measure it. This is a center, this is 0 degree. As you can see here, this is 120 degree we obtain. Continue with the next one. Now we'll construct the 30 degree. As we know, 30 degree is half of 60 degree. So let us construct first 60 and we'll do the half of it. So again, as we have done earlier, we'll construct 60 first and we'll discuss that 60 is the base of all the angles. So this is ray point OA. To construct 60 degree, we should take the arbitrary radius, any measure. We have taken 2 here, O as a center, and we should draw arc. You can see that this arc intersecting ray OA at a point, that is M. Keep the same radius, M as a center, and we should construct an arc. So now it is intersecting and this is point N. Now we know that 30 should lies here, that is it passing from the half of this. That means we have to construct the bisector of 60. Now remember students, there are many questions we'll do further in which we have to construct the bisector of the given angle. So whenever we have to construct the bisector, so here the bisector of 60. So what we'll do, again as we discussed, the radius would be the same. M as a center and we should construct an arc. And now N, which is the 60 degree, and we should construct an arc. So here you can see that if I'll consider this point M as a 0 degree and point N as 60 degree. So one arc I have constructed from 0 degree and one I have constructed from 60 degree. So 0 plus 60, and if I'll do the half of it, so I'll get the 30 degree. So this intersecting point, if I'll give point P, let me just draw this ray OP. This is point B, Bombay. So AOB must be half of 60 and it would be 30. So let us measure with the help of protractor to check whether it is right or wrong. So as you can see that this is A, O and B and it is 30 degree. So thus how 30 degree should be constructed. Further we'll do the bisector of the given angle. That means now we have to construct 15 degree, 15, which is a bisector of 30 degree. So to construct 15 degree, again we'll construct 30 degree as we have just seen in the previous angle. So again we should construct a ray. Let us give that name OA. Point O and A. To construct 30 degree, we should draw 60 first. Again, the arbitrary radius, I have taken 2 cm, O as a center and an arc. This arc intersecting here at point M. Again, M as a center, we should construct this arbitrary radius of the same measure which intersect here point N. It becomes 60. As we required 15, so first we need to go for the 30. For 30, look at this, from point M, we should draw an arc. And from point N, we should draw another arc. So this intersecting point P, if I'll say that, so we should draw this ray. But as it is 30, so remember we should draw the dotted line. Why? Because this is not our main angle. You can see that 3 dot or dash I have done, one at the point of intersecting, another at the main arc and one at the center. You can draw the line also, but as we have to construct 15 degrees, so we should keep it dotted line. So we can identify that this is not the angle we require. Let me give this point at P. Now again we have to construct the bisector. So as we discussed earlier, that the bisector of 30 degree. Now, this point M, as we discussed earlier, has a 0 degree. So, I'll construct an arc. Now, at point P, which is 30 degree. So, I'll construct another arc from point P. So, look at the students, what I have done, I explained here. To construct the bisector, we have to draw the two arc from 0 degree and the 60, so I got 30. Here, we have to construct the bisector of 30 degree. So, one arc we have taken from 0 degree and another we have taken from 30 degree. Humne do arcs lagaye. Ek, one we construct from 30 degree and one we construct from 0 degree. So, 30 plus 0. So, half of 30, that is 15. So, this is the intersecting point. If I will give that point Q, let me join OQ. So, now this point and angle AOB, it must be 15 degree. Let us check with the help of protractor. You can see that A, O and B. See, that is the between 10 and 20. So, angle AOB, that is of 15 degree. So, thus we discussed that how to construct the bisectors of the given angle.